Welcome to another UEN Teacher Tip. I'm Rob Bentley. Over the last few years, the demand for podcasts has steadily increased. Podcasts are audio or video files that can be downloaded or streamed over the internet. There are podcasts on a variety of topics, including news and education, entertainment, and storytelling. Students and teachers are using podcasts in several ways. For example, students use podcasts as a way to practice their listening comprehension skills and as supplemental learning materials. Teachers use podcasts for professional development and as a way to start classroom discussion. Teachers and students are also creating their own podcasts. In this teacher tip, I will show you a fantastic tool from Adobe that can help jumpstart your own podcasting journey. It's called Adobe Podcast. Let's take a look. To begin using Adobe Podcast, you'll need to go to podcast.adobe.com. Adobe Podcast is still in beta, but you should be able to sign into it using your Adobe account. Once you've signed in, if you scroll down the page a ways, you'll find three powerful podcasting tools. Let's focus on the Podcast Studio. I'll click Go to Studio, and then click New Project. That takes me to a screen where I can upload pre-recorded audio by clicking here, or I can simply start recording a new podcast episode. I'll click the record button to begin my new episode. I will then just talk about whatever my topic is. When I'm finished, I'll click stop recording, and a transcript is created of the words that I said, including any mistakes that I've made or filler words that I used. At that point, I can go into the transcript and click to delete mistakes or long pauses. And when I delete those mistakes or pauses from the transcript, they're also deleted from the recording itself. If there's a spelling error or other mistake in the transcript, I can click on the misspelled word and click to correct the transcript. Then I just click the check mark button to record the correction. If I choose to, I can add music to my podcast episode by clicking here. I could also record a second part of the same episode just by clicking the record button again. When I'm all finished creating my podcast episode, I can go to the download button in the upper right corner of the screen to download the audio and transcript of the episode. Teachers might also think about clicking the share button in the upper right to turn their podcast episode into a template and then share that template with students and colleagues. Anyone who has the template link will be able to start a new project from this template. As it says here, with the link, people can duplicate this project. They can edit their own version, but not yours. Once you've downloaded your podcast episode, you can submit it to a podcast platform, upload it into Canvas, post it on the school website, or simply send it to your intended audience. So I hope you'll try making your own teacher or class podcast. And we'll see you next time on the next UEN Teacher Tip.